the man woman, in a union so intimate and so tender, they were to be called no longer twain, but one flesh. So marriage comes to us from paradise with the smile and the blessing of God upon it. When we think of marriage, we think of the home. And when we think of the home, we think of all that is sacred and tender in human life. And so these two, Mark MacDonald and Marla Mostyn, have come before me for the purpose of being united in the holy bond of matrimony. Who giveth this bridegroom?
Her mother and I.
The Bible reveals unto us that God is love. Henry Drummond said that love was the greatest thing in all of the world. And certainly it is the greatest word in the world. The love chapter of the New Testament is 1 Corinthians 13. It has been called a photograph of the Lord Jesus Christ in his inner character. You can read the 1 Corinthians 13 chapter and substitute Jesus every time the word love appears, and it fits in perfectly. And may his love be reproduced in your lives as you establish your home. If I had the gift of being able to speak in other languages without learning them, and could speak in every language there is in all of heaven and earth, but didn't love others, I would only be making noise. If I had the gift of prophecy and knew all about what is going to happen in the future, knew everything about everything, but didn't love others, what good would it do? Even if I had the gift of faith so that I could speak to a mountain and make it move, I would still be worth nothing at all without love. If I gave everything I have to poor people, and if I were burned alive for preaching the gospel, but didn't love others, it would be of no value whatsoever. Love is very patient and kind, never jealous nor envious, never boastful or proud, never haughty or selfish or rude. Love does not demand its own way. It is not irritable or touchy. It does not hold grudges and will hardly even notice when others do it wrong. It is never glad about injustice, but rejoices whenever truth wins out. If you love someone, you will be loyal to him no matter what the cost. You will always believe in him, always expect the best of him, and always stand your ground in defending him. All the special gifts and powers from God will someday come to an end, but love goes on forever. Someday prophecy and speaking in unknown languages and special knowledge, these gifts will disappear. Now we know so little, even with our special gifts, and the preaching of those most gifted is still so poor. But when we have been made perfect and complete, then the need for these inadequate special gifts will come to an end, and they will disappear. It is like this. When I was a child, I spoke and thought and reasoned as a child does. But when I became a man, my thoughts grew far beyond those of my childhood, and now I have put away the childish things. In the same way, we can see and understand only a little about God now, as if we were peering at his reflection in a poor mirror. But someday we are going to see him in his completeness, face to face. Now all that I know is hazy and blurry. lawful and wedded wife. And do you promise to love, honor, and protect her in sickness as in health, in poverty as in wealth, for better or for worse, and forsaking all others, cleaving only unto her, so long as you both shall live? Marla, do you take Mark, who stands by your side, and whom you hold by the hand, to be your lawful and wedded husband? And do you promise to love, honor, and cherish him in sickness as in health, in poverty as in wealth, for better or for worse, and forsaking all others, cleaving only unto him, so long as you both shall live? From time immemorial, the ring has been used as a seal of important vows and covenants. Its circle, having neither beginning nor end, is symbolical of the imperishableness of the vows which you now mutually take. Mark, place this on Marla's finger and hold it just a moment. Mark, do you give this ring to Marla as a seal of the vows that you have just taken and as a token of your love for her? Marla, do you accept it, and will you promise to wear it always as a reminder of your love for Mark? Wedding band is made from precious metal without alloy. And it's my prayer that your love, each for the other, might always be precious and without alloy. Would you place this on Mark's finger and hold this? Marla, do you give this ring to Mark as a seal of the vows that you have just made and as a token of your love for him? Mark, do you accept it, and will you promise to wear it always as a reminder of your love for Marla? You may reunite your right hands. Having then heard your vows of fidelity and believing them to be secure and sincere, I hereby pronounce you husband and wife. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, as we stand at this sacred place, we pray thy richest blessings upon Mark and Marla as they leave to establish their home. We pray if it could be in the providence of your will that their lives might be crowned with health and happiness and prosperity. But above all, we pray that they will make thee the center of their home, the unseen guest at every meal, and that their love, each for the other, will be akin to that love manifested by the Heavenly Father in the gift of his only begotten Son. For we ask these things in Jesus' name and for his dear sake. Amen. You may seal your vows with a kiss.
Thank you.
I'll do it this time, so you can feel free to begin to eat when you arrive. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, again, we thank thee for this joyous and happy occasion. We thank thee for Marla and for Mark, and we pray your blessing upon them. We thank thee for the families from which they come and all the relatives and friends. We pray that you will bless the reception and brunch, the food that has been prepared, and the blessed to the nourishment of our bodies. For we ask it in Jesus' name for his dear sake. Amen. Here is my
It went real good.
I didn't even know you were there.
Good. I was worried about that.
I'm ready when you are. Right.